More than 150 people have come to this party in Los Angeles to show support for an organization promoting transgender awareness. Born into a body which does not match their gender identity, transgender people struggle to gain society's acceptance, even within the LGBT community. This group hopes to unite transgender youth and put an end to their alienation.
The hiding is over, everyone's out, everyone's having a lovely time, and everyone's being themselves. We are seen as human beings. So many people don't even realize that transgender people exist.
Well, I just wanted to, again, thank you.
The host of the event, Gina Rosero, is a leading figure in the transgender community. Blazing a trail with her career as a top fashion model, she's dedicated to helping other transgender people live out and proud.
My dream is for young people to be able to pursue their dream and make sure that they have the support system. A lot of young trans people does not have support system. You know, 40% of LGBT homeless youth, that's a lot of numbers. So I hope that they really know that their dreams are possible.
In September, the world focuses its attention on New York City for Fashion Week. The media and style leaders flock here to see and be seen. All the models here have gone through a rigorous casting process, and Gina is one of them. Philippine-born Gina has been at the top of the modeling industry for 10 years.
You know, walking that runway is like magic. You're just like floating and you're just feeling the most beautiful person at that moment. Like, oh, the gratitude coming from my heart and just exploding. And I'm just so full of gratitude. Okay.
I've never seen a picture of her before she made her transition. So for me, she's just a beautiful woman. I have nothing to compare her to or against except other beautiful women, and she's right up on top of that list for me.
Gina has reached the height of the fashion industry, but the road to the top was full of obstacles. Gina was born in Manila and was assigned as a boy in the hospital. From a young age, she identified as female. She suffered bullying for her gender identity, but her mother, a school teacher, accepted that Gina was transgender. Gina's life changed at age 17, when her mother, who had immigrated to the U.S., called her to tell her that in this country, you could legally change your name and gender assignation.
And she told me that there is a specific policy in California that would allow me to change my name and gender marker on my documents. And that was huge. That was my ultimate dream. Besides, you know, maybe wanting to become a model, that's my dream. To see in your documents, on your driver's license or your passport, as the woman that you are, that changed the whole thing for me.
Moving to America, Gina was legally recognized as a woman, but she would soon discover that in this country, transgender people suffer serious discrimination. Many transgender youth face homelessness after being rejected by their families and resort to suicide. In America, Gina kept her transgender identity a secret. She was working at a restaurant in New York City when she was scouted by a photographer. The picture he took launched her modeling career. Before long, she had established herself as a top model. But deep down, she felt her success was overshadowed by the reality that the whole time she was concealing a large part of herself from the world.
I would be working as a model and it was successful because I'm finally now a model. And at the same time, on the other side of it, I would be so afraid that what if a gossip around me would come out that I'm a trans woman, that I would be outed and my career would be over. And I would be at work and sometimes I'll feel depressed. Or I would go to casting, I would be so paranoid. So it, you know, in a way, I was living my dream, but I was also afraid.
Unable to bear the secret any longer, Gina made a decision. With 9 years of modeling behind her, at age 30, she decided to come out. She chose to do it at last year's TED conference, where prominent figures from various fields present their ideas to the internet.
For the last 9 years, some of my neighbors, some of my friends, colleagues, even my agent did not know about my history. I think in mystery, this is called a reveal. Here is mine. I was assigned boy at birth based on the appearance of my genitalia. And my mom asked me.
This is the moment she first disclosed what she had hidden for so long, with the possibility that the public might not accept a transgender person in the role of a fashion model.
Today, this very moment is my real coming out. I could no longer live my truth for and by myself. I want to do my best to help others live their truth without shame and terror. Thank you.
And I remember after being, you know, backstage and people were just so wonderful, they were crying, they gave me a hug, and it was, I think I did something right, you know, and people connected with it.
Gina's TED Talk video went viral and has been viewed nearly 3 million times. She is now recognized as a leader in the transgender community and was invited to the White House to speak in front of President Obama. She launched a nonprofit group, Gender Proud, to support transgender youth who struggle with the kind of discrimination she faced herself.
Give a piece of advice. As women,
she regularly speaks at events to encourage understanding of transgender people.
You can't do that.
We're having for the trans identity, you know, like people would think, oh, we have Caitlyn Jenner. Of course we've had equality. It's not. We're far from it. No. We're not even close to it.
No.
It's, you know, we've had this amazing visibility, but it's been the most violent for transgender community for this year. It is a risk because we live in the world that constantly dictates us as there is a certain way to be a woman. There's this rule. There's this, you have to be feminine enough. Oh, maybe not so feminine enough. Yeah. And I can't have that. You know, I have to follow that core. And
a round of applause for that. I mean, I happen to be
just hearing her story and hearing how she's really made it and loves herself and accepts herself and is like, this is me. Everyone should accept me for me because that's who I am. And I think it's just really inspiring.
I'm of another generation when none of this was spoken about. Everybody hid, and it was so painful to watch. So this is just such a breath of fresh air that everybody's talking and accepting now.
She has also started devoting her personal time and resources to supporting young transgender people with big dreams.
How are you?
I'm good, how are you?
Pat Cordova is one of these young people.
Thank you, I know, it's new.
I want one.
Pat is a second-year political science student at a community college in Los Angeles. Like Gina, Pat faced bullying as a child and grew up without a lot of friends. An avid student, she was always at the top of her class at school and won a college scholarship. Her dream is to go into politics.
I want to, you know, go into office and be a politician to represent, you know, the transgender community, you know, the, you know, people who are of color, you know, poor people, you know, every person who I know that I used, that I am, that isn't always represented.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Good.
They pick, you know.
Gina has tapped into her network and managed to connect Pat with an LGBT political action group. An internship at the group could be a first step towards Pat's dream of entering politics.
They would, you know, give you allowance and stipend. And they said, let us know if Pat is interested. We're happy to do that with her. Do you think it's something that you would like to explore?
Oh, I'm crying. Oh my gosh. Well, yes.
I wanted to support Pat because I saw something in her that I could totally relate in her drive and her vision.
Now, Gina is launching a new project to promote the dreams of trans youth. In collaboration with an American television network, she's producing a reality series.
Shots like that, you know, it's nice.
Yeah, no, it's good.
Something.
Yeah.
Today, she's recording spots as an on-camera host and doing her first ever turn as a narrator.
All of us leaders in the trans community is unrivaled. From Teek and Kim's experiences. Teek and Kim.
How do you feel right now?
I feel like my mouth is drying up. I'm just, you know, when you repeat something over and over and over and then you're so nervous and you're trying. And, you know, I can't wait to see the whole thing, you know, and like the whole process from beginning to end.
The series has 4 episodes, including one telling Pat's story.
Beautiful As I Want to Be is a series that gives young trans people the opportunity to define beauty on their own terms. Dreams. In this episode, we will meet Pat, a young, motivated activist looking to change the world.
My name is Pat. I'm 18 years old, and I am from Azusa, California. My 8th grade year of junior high, my parents became unemployed. I had been homeless for about 4 years in high school. I definitely have gained a passion for politics and the government and kind of creating change through legislation. About a year ago, I was on the streets. You know, in about 15 years, I hope to be in the White House.
To celebrate the debut of the series, Gina has organized a launch party.
Beyond the bounds of gender.
The evening features a special screening premiering the first episode.
Remaking and manipulating boundaries. Exhibiting art in your daily life is something we already do.
Yeah, I think every time I attend an event with other people who are like me, other people who understand who I am, I feel empowered to be myself and to continue my work.
It was so inspiring. I've never seen a video that was so honest and so real.
It's a new year, and 2016, there's gonna be a lot more freedom. Like now, it's not necessarily you are, you aren't, but just you can do whatever you want.
By helping transgender people support each other, Gina is moving closer to her dream of a society where everyone can live as they truly are.
That we could do it, like life is possible, that if you really dream of wanting to do something out of yourself, you could dream about it and it's possible. As long as you ask for support and help, you should do it. Yeah.